Hello there, welcome back to The Closet Historian. Today I have another collections management video for you all. We're back to form with these videos today because the last couple of videos I did my straw hats. I'll put a card up to that one since it seems many people for some reason weren't interested in that one or just didn't, maybe it missed sub boxes or something like that. I don't really know how the algorithm works, but not many people seem to be interested in that one, and I think straw hats are quite exciting. And I did model all of those hats, which of course took ages, and today I will not be modeling my novelty brooches for you. So the last two videos I did the hats and the gloves, I did them a little bit differently, but I'm back to form how I did the rest of my jewelry collection because I am doing more jewelry today. So today I will be showing you all of my novelty brooches or just brooches, all my brooches that didn't fit in the other two categories that I did for this video. So I did do a collections management video on my gold toned vintage brooches and on my silver toned vintage brooches. I will again put cards up to those if I can. Those earlier videos, just showing that part of my collection. Today I'm just showing the rest of my brooches, the novelty ones, so cute shapes, animals, bugs, things like that, and then also different materials like celluloid or wood or plastic, different materials that didn't fit into the other two categories. So I will be showing you the rest of my brooches today, but I am back to form, kind of just showing them statically. I do apologize for that, but if I were to model every brooch for you, I do fear that we would be here for a very long time today. That's also the reason I don't usually give the story behind each item in videos, in my collections management videos, just because most items I don't have a story for. Usually it's like, I wanted a red celluloid brooch, so I typed into Etsy, red celluloid brooch, and I bought one. And that's usually the full extent of the story. It's never like something cute like, ooh, I was in this little village in France and I went into this store and this lady brought me into her back room. No, it's not nothing cute like that. I don't pick up most of my vintage on my travels, or not that I've been traveling lately, or like anywhere particularly exciting. Usually I'm just shopping online, as I've talked about here on the channel, and like shopping quite strategically. So of my vintage collection, not many items have a story to them. Maybe a handful of things. If you would like a video just talking about those things, items that do have a little bit more of a backstory to them, I think I could probably collect a few of them for my collection, but not many. But I could do a separate video just on items with a story, perhaps, if that's something you're interested in, let me know in the comments below. But today I'm just going to be showing you all of my brooches. It's just going to be like a show not tell, just of all of the rest of my brooches. You can see the things that I have in my collection, the things that I have collected, and then I will list information next to them. If I know the date or the maker, things like that, I will put that information on screen as well. But a lot of these I don't know. Things that are in more low quality, not low quality, but like lesser quote unquote materials like wood or celluloid as compared to like costume jewelry, trefari brooches, usually these things aren't marked as much. So unlike my gold and silver brooches, which often do have a costume jeweler's mark on the back, these things don't tend to have that kind of mark. So I will put the information if I have it, but if not, I will just leave the screen blank and let you enjoy the various brooches that I have in my collection. So before I ramble on anymore, as we can see, if you let me talk, the videos will be 6 hours long, and not everyone wants to be here for 6 hours, I'm afraid. If you let me ramble on, I will keep going. But instead, let's just jump on in and I'll show you the rest of my brooch collection. So those were all of my brooches that I didn't show in my other two videos, basically. All of my novelty brooches, all of my brooches and pins made out of different materials, basically. My more modern ones I threw in here as well. And so that's the rest of my brooch collection as it stands today, of course. I will, of course, probably be adding more to this collection eventually, even though I do have a billion, as we just saw. I will actually count them up and put the number down here, because I'm not sure off the top of my head how many brooches we had in this video today, but I just know it was a lot. Thank you for tuning in today and watching me go through my collection a little bit more and show you some more of the things that I have in my closet. And if you are interested in seeing a different part of my collection, do let me know what you'd like to see next in the comments below, and I will see you all again here on the channel soon. Bye.